Well, hello and welcome back to my channel, Make Life Simple with Sandy. Y'all, I hope I don't have lipstick on my teeth. I hope y'all are having a wonderful day. I am headed to work. I'm running a little late, but that's the story of my life. Just want to do a quick update. I am working on my giveaway. I promise. My husband had his heart cath. There was no blockages. Praise the Lord. So pleased about that, because this shortness of breath that he was having and this fatigue is just so not like him. But, and I hope the lighting's okay, y'all. I got the top down, so it's a beautiful day. It looks like he's wearing a heart monitor now. He's gonna have to wear it for, I think, 2 weeks, I believe. And they're actually monitoring him now by satellite. It's just, isn't technology cool? I remember I had to wear one back several years ago and had to bring it back in, and they had to take the readings off of it. He's doing good, y'all. It looks like he has AFib due to sleep apnea. Now, that just blew me away. It don't make no sense, but evidently it can happen. All right. But this 2-week heart monitor is going to tell something, and then depending on what it tells, he may have to go in. I'm sorry, the radio's up. He may have to go in for a sleep study, okay? And they think it can be controlled with medications. They did mention, I think, an ablation where they go in there and kill some nerves or something, but we're not looking at that right now. We're thinking medication may be able to take care of it. Okay. He's doing good, and I am so tickled. Y'all, the heart cath done, it was great. They went through his wrist. He still has to be a little bit careful of his wrist, but other than that, he's doing good. It's just good news all around. We was home by 7 o'clock that night. I think they come got him and took him back probably around. We had to be there at noon. They come and got him probably around 2 or 3 o'clock. Something like that. But anyhow, smooth as silk, no problem. Just went perfect. Let's see, what else? Okay, my brother is doing just the Valcade once a week, every Tuesday. He's doing the Decadron every Tuesday and Friday. He's doing that Zometa, whatever it is, once a month on Tuesdays. On that day, he doesn't get the Valcade, I believe. He's doing good. He's trying to get all of his stuff into Jackson because of his stem cell. He's not able to pay for the stem cell transplant, so he's got to send in paperwork where he hadn't worked like in 5 years, you know, or hadn't had an income in 5 years, and some other stuff like that. And he's on a deadline this Friday, and you know how the Internal Revenue Service, they don't get in no hurry. He's waiting on some papers for them to send some papers to him so he can send them in. I thought, my goodness. So I told him, I said, I just wonder if they could just send them straight to the hospital in Jackson. So I don't know. But anyhow, he's doing good. He is having a lot of leg pain, y'all. I woke up a couple times last night and said a little prayer for him. He's not a complainer. He's never complained. But about this last 3 weeks or so, he's mentioned leg pain, you know, so. Which they told him they can control his pain, but he don't want to take nothing. So, but other than that, he's doing good. He's working in his garden and doing some work on his house. He's put some tile down. He's put some new floors down. He's painted, and he just has his good days and his bad days. And I'm wanting to go see him again because I just miss him. I ain't seen him in over a month. All right, so there's that. Then there's me, who went to the surgery center yesterday to have this cyst removed off my finger again. My doctor did it, but didn't get it all because it was wrapped around the tendon, and he didn't want to go in there. He wanted me to go to a hand surgeon, because it was attached to the tendon or close to the tendon. So I went there yesterday and met with him, and Dr. Dolan is his name, and he is very good. He's very good. He rattled off what it possibly was, and he said, if it's this kind of cyst, there's a 1 in 4 chance coming back. If it's this kind of cyst, there's a 1 in 3 chance coming back. So he didn't take it off yesterday. I was hoping he would, but he's rescheduled me for next week, and I got to be there at like 7:30, and just, he ain't putting me to sleep, just going to do a local. And but they was talking about antibiotics and pain meds and nausea medicine, and I'm thinking, what the what? It don't seem like that big of a deal to me, but evidently it is if it's close to the tendon. So, and then I'll have to wear a finger splint for, I think he said 10 days or 2 weeks. Soak it, put the splint back on, because that tendon needs, if he has to split the tendon, he said it's going to take a while to heal. I've got to be very careful so the tendon will heal back right. So anyhow, I walk around like pointing my finger at everybody. And I just told my husband, I said, well, I'm glad it ain't my middle finger, you know. So I'd be getting people cussing me out because I thought I was shooting them the bird or something. But anyhow, so I don't know if I'm going to do that now or I'm going to wait. With everything that's going on with my husband and all, I'm thinking, well, I may push that on out into the summer when things are a little bit more settled, because May's a busy month. You know, we've got dance recitals and kindergarten graduations and awards days and all this kind of stuff, you know, for May. May's just busy. Mother's Day and all that. So, but anyhow, so that's where we're at, y'all. I'm headed into work. I had to take my husband Monday to get that monitor on, so we were late. I come in, worked, and got some closings done then. Wrote a few earnest money checks, and then of course was off all day yesterday in Jackson, so here I am again. If I didn't own this place, I'd probably get fired, reckon. But I hope y'all have a wonderful, wonderful Wednesday. Happy hump day, everybody. I'm gonna just get in here and try to get as much stuff as I can done and then get back home. And I've got my empties is overflowing. I still ain't done that Bath and Body Works haul. And I've still gotta work on my giveaway. But thank y'all so much. Oops, I need to move. Here's a little FYI. If you're in a convertible and you got the top down, don't park under power lines. That's where the birds sit. And what else do the birds do? Be very careful about parking under trees and under power lines, because you may get a mess in your car. So, but y'all, thank you so much. I really appreciate the prayers. Y'all have just been so sweet and so kind and so patient, and I really, really do appreciate it. So, but thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day, and God bless.